It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Gauzapole family. Norbert, Evelyn, Jerry, Fred, and John. Ready for action. And the Brown family. Marion, Patrice, Ellis, Tina, and Ron. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome to our show. We get together once a week, meet a couple of nice families. They get a chance to win a lot of money. One of the families will go for over $10,000. If you watch our show regularly, you will... I heard someone say, hold it. I have... Well, no, I hate it when they come up and go, ooh, and hold it. All right, don't hold it. Put a freeze on the hold. But if you watch our show regularly, you will know that this darling family, Gauzapole, is that how I say it? They were here once before, and we had a little something. We thought maybe there's a doubt. They lost. We brought them back so they can maybe win enough money, get a reasonable name like Black or something like that. So anyway, let's welcome both of them. Here they are, the Gauzapole. There you go. How you doing?
Very good.
Good.
Very
good. What a nice.
You better
believe. They're applauding you there. That's very sweet. Let's meet these rascals. I've met them before a long time ago, but I've forgotten.
Well, Richard, this is my wife of 38 years, Evelyn, my middle son, Jerry, my oldest son, Fred, and the youngest of the family, John.
They look exactly the way I remember them. In fact, I think they had the same clothes on, if I'm not mistaken. You're a pawnbroker now.
Yes.
You were a teacher.
I was a teacher.
And you retired.
So I thought, but I'm working harder now than
ever. You retired as a teacher?
As a teacher.
Yeah. Do you buy anything hot to...
Not if we can help it. Why, do you have something hot you want to try to get rid of?
It's an unplugged iron. We're trying to... No. Here's the family going to challenge you right now. Call the Browns. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Delighted to have you here.
And I'm glad to be here.
Let's meet your family, please.
My daughter, Patrice.
Hello.
My son, Ellis. My son, Ronald. And my daughter, Tina.
Ronald looks quite surly there. What's the matter, Ron? A little smile, Ron. There you go. Nothing wrong wearing braces, is there?
Oh, not
because
the
it
cost
makes a great
of them.
Smile. I know that. Yeah. Boy, oh boy.
It's expensive.
Yeah. My dentist said to me about my son, got to have braces, you know, for college. He meant his kids going through college. You ready to do it?
Yeah.
Come on, let's play the Feud. That's a pretty dress.
Thank you.
Now, remember, this all works up to one thing, the right to play for $10,000, okay? I must get a room. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. When you come in late at night, name something you do quietly. Oh, I didn't finish that. What do you say?
Open the door.
You open the door. All right. Open the door! Okay. I'll finish the question. One answer is better than that, so I'll finish it. When you come in late at night, name something you do quietly so as not to wake others.
Tiptoe.
Through the tulip?
All right. That's a good one.
Through the tulip?
Just through the house.
Oh, no, not through the tulip.
No, no. Just through the house.
Well, that usually means you've had a couple, right? Tiptoe! You got it. What are you going to do?
Let him play.
We're going
to
play.
It sounds like a bunch of stay-outs to me. They want to play this. They're going to play it, Angel. All right. Now, there's $77 there now, and $300 gets you the chance to go for the big money. How are you, sweetheart?
Oh, pretty good. Something you do quietly. Raid the refrigerator very quietly.
Very quietly.
A good one.
Good one.
Good one.
The old quiet raid. Well done. I didn't get a kiss from you. Thank you. You got a good looking bunch of boys here. How you doing?
So. Richard, how you doing?
Now, I'm sure you've come in late quite often. But
no, not me.
Well, when you do, name something you do quietly so as not to wake others.
Take off your clothes.
That's a good answer. That's a good one. There's nothing worse than hearing a tie just thud on the floor. I go, oh, what was that? It was just a... Take off your clothes! There you go. I'm amazed. What do you say, Fred?
If there's more than one person coming in, you whisper, you don't talk.
Good one.
Yeah. Good fun.
When you come in late at night, doesn't mention whether anybody's there, but maybe.
Especially
yeah.
One.
Yeah. And if you're a little bomb, you probably talk to yourself anyway. We probably whisper. Is it there? Not July with that buzzer. You wake everybody up. That's a strike. If you get three of those, they get a chance to steal. John, you come in late at night, name something you do quietly so as not to wake others.
Get in bed very quietly.
Good one. That's good. Good one.
We're looking to see if any of our 100 people said, get in bed quietly. $86 there. One answer left, one strike. Browns are over there plotting. What are you saying, Over?
I say he stole my answer, so I'll have to reach way out and say, leave the lights off.
Good one.
That's good.
That's good.
That's good. The lights off. Good. Yeah.
That and the old tie thudding. Well, if I hear a light go on, I... All right, just turn the lights on. Oh, you leave them off, is that right?
Right.
Leave them off. Leave the lights off for all the money, please. When you come in late at night, name something you do quietly so not to wake others.
Play the radio very low.
Play it.
Okay. Low.
That's all right.
Music
low. That's all right.
Music low.
I love to listen to radio about 4:30 in the morning. Just first thing I do. That and the refrigerator. Play that old radio. It's up there. You've got it all. If not, get ready because I'm going to come over there, give you a chance to steal. Play radio! What do you say,
Mark? Yeah, right. Go to the bathroom.
What do you say, Mark?
Go to the bathroom quietly.
Right. Yeah, okay, that's Mom. That's
it. When people talk about that, I just flush. I mean, flush. Go to the bathroom. It's up there. You get the $86. If not, Norbert will give it to you. Go to the bathroom. You know, I did all of those things for 3 years, and then I remembered I lived alone. $86 right there. Nothing right there. Evelyn, come on. Patrice. She's okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm rude, aren't I?
No, you're not rude. You were preoccupied.
Yes,
there.
I was.
Remember, 300 is that magic number you're trying to get. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. Here's the question. What one bad habit do people have that they'd most like to lose? Yeah.
Quit smoking.
Yeah, nasty.
Good.
Smoking! Is one answer even better?
Drinking.
Three says drinking. Not there. Oh, goodness, you control it. What are you going to do?
Okay,
play. Stay out late and have bad habits, obviously. One bad habit people have they'd like to most to lose.
Biting fingernails.
Uh-huh.
Hey, that's okay. A good one. Yeah, that's a good one.
I hope it's there. Fingernail biting, number one. 38 people said it. Right?
I would think that using bad language.
Good one.
That's a good one.
I hope that's good.
You're just a little pure for me, Fred, if you don't mind me saying so. Using bad language. That's a strike. John, one bad habit that people would like most to lose.
How about interrupting people while they're talking?
That's a good one.
That's good.
That's a good one. That's good. Yeah.
Right. Don't interrupt. That's a very bad habit. Is it there? Not there. You got two strikes here, Norman. Three answers left. What one bad habit people have they'd most like to lose?
Staying out late.
Good one.
From the last question. Very clever the way you work that all in. Staying out late's up there, you get to say, no, you'll be okay, actually. But if not, I'm going to go over there, my love. Marion. They're shooting craps here. Staying out late! Not there. What do you say?
Overeating. Overeating. Cracking your knuckles.
Overeating. 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 Overeating.
I need an answer. What do you say?
Overeating.
Okay.
All right, come on, Mom.
Come on, Mom.
Overeating up there. You get that $71, take a big lead in the game, and if it's not, Norbert and his gang get the money. Overeating! Number four, please.
Oh, yeah.
Who had cracking knuckles? I heard that. Very good. And number five? Talking too much. Going to commercials, that's another thing, isn't it? I've got to break myself of that. We'll be back right after this. Those people back, don't let them get near this game. I'm just looking at it. Oh, it's fascinating. Worth every penny. Ages 10 to adult. Object, name the most popular answers and win money. And it's called the Family Feud Home Game. There's a little picture of me in there. You'll get one each, okay?
Thank you.
Don't get choked up about it. All right. 157, nothing there. Let's go, sir. Well, 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an occupation whose members often seem grouchy.
Yes. Police department.
Hey, police. Policeman. Policeman. There he is. Oh. That was one better than that.
Personnel worker, handing out jobs.
Doo-da. Personnel worker. Nah, you control it. What are you going to do?
Pass.
What are you going to do?
Let's play. Pass it.
Play.
Come on, let's play.
Play
it, Richard.
You are? You listen to Fred. They're going to play out. All right, Fred, an occupation whose members often seem grouchy.
How about a teacher?
Teacher?
Good one.
All right.
Show us. Teacher, please. But that's, they have a lot of reason to be glad. They don't get a lot of money and a lot of overcrowded conditions. I like teachers. But that's what most people say. What do you say?
How about a judge?
Good one.
That's good.
Want to see a judge, please? Not there. Norbert, an occupation whose members often seem grouchy, sir.
A doctor.
Doctor.
Good one.
Doctor grouchy. 100 people surveyed and he say doctor. They didn't?
Oh, that really puts me on the spot.
It certainly does. Say it a secret word.
Well, I've never been in contact with one, but I'll see a parole officer.
You will.
I'll see a good one.
That's all right.
Parole officers up there are okay. If not, I'm coming over there. You've done it twice. You can do it again. A parole officer. You want to steal that money? Give me an answer.
Come on, Bob.
Cashier.
Sorry,
need an answer.
Cashiers.
Cashier.
I hate to say that because I'm a cashier. Yeah, I'm nice and friendly.
Cashiers, then you get $34, a big lead. If not, you're in this game. Cashier! You're in the game. Number three, please. Bus driver. Number four. Sales clerk. And number five. Yeah. That's Iris. I know her very IRS. 157 there. 34 there. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Tell me a phony name people use in hotel. Yep.
John Doe.
Nope. One.
Smith.
Aha, uh-huh, you've been there. Smith. Well done. What are you going to do?
Play.
We're going to play.
You're going to play. Okay. Well done. Looks so young, but he's caught on to it quite. Hi, darling.
Hi.
Tell me a phony name people use in hotel.
Jones.
Jones.
All right. Good answer.
Show us if it's there. Jones. We've got it. 178. Mary and my flower, tell me a phony name people use in hotel.
Brown.
Brown. You got this one, darling. You're going to play for $10,000.
Okay,
tell me a phony name people use in hotel.
Okay, Johnson.
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 Johnson, good answer.
Oh, I hope so.
Johnson's there. You've done it. Show us Johnson. Oh, they did it, huh? You can call me Gigi. Got $34 for you and nice prizes. And we know this time it was a fair shot. We're happy that we were able to give you that chance.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Who's going to play Fast Money? Let's go. Who go first? Who's going first? Okay. All right, well, let me see you kiss that woman. We'll be back right after this. You need to. Thank you. You did it, Angel. You just got it. Well, you did it, didn't you?
Yeah.
And here you are. How old are you?
20.
You're a very pretty girl.
Thank you.
Now, Crazy Ellis, your brother's offstage earphone dog.
Okay.
Can't hear us. Mm-hmm. You gonna speak up for me when we play this?
I'll try.
Try really hard, because it's worth $10,000
to
you.
Yeah, I'll holler.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll ask you 5 questions.
Okay.
Three, 5 answers, 15 seconds you got for that. You and Ellis get 200 points, $10,000, 15 seconds. Name something a surgeon keeps near him when he works.
Scalpel.
A football penalty.
Clipping.
Something in a phone book.
Names.
A birthstone.
Ruby.
One of the armed services.
Air Force.
Turn around. Good girl. Name something a surgeon keeps near him when he works, I asked. And you said scalpel. Our survey said...
All right!
Scalpel. Football penalty. Also a barber penalty. You said... Clipping. A survey said...
Oh, yeah!
Right now. A 66. Something in a phone book. You said... Name. That's right.
Okay.
Sure. A survey said...
Oh, yeah!
21. That is 7. A birthstone. You said... Ruby Vagunia. Is that your birthstone?
No, mine's diamond.
Oh, is it really?
I thought of it after I said
Well, that's
Ruby,
a good answer, Ruby. Our survey said...
Okay.
One of the armed services, and you said, there we go, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I helped write that, and I get royalty.
Yeah.
Our survey said...
Okay.
You got 1 third of the clear. Turn the board, please. Good job. Off you go. Here's Ellis. Let's do it. Right now. You are 67 away from the big money. Your sister did okay. Don't turn around anymore. And I'm going to ask the same questions I asked Tina. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear that. I say try again. You give me another answer, okay?
All righty.
Want you to speak up. Please remind everyone the excellent answers Tina gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something a surgeon keeps near him when he works.
Scalpel.
Try again.
Scissors.
A football penalty. Penalty.
Passing. Not passing. Over offsides.
Something in a phone book.
Yellow pages.
A birthstone.
Opal.
One of the armed services.
Air Force.
Try again.
Navy.
Okay. Navy. Turn around. .67 points winning, something a surgeon keeps near him when he works. And you said, scissors. Our survey said, 3. Number one answer, scalpel. You gave it to me, Angel. Now, football penalty. You went bananas there, didn't you? Little Tina said clipping right away. But anyway, well, you said, officer. Our survey said, 39. That was the number one answer. Offside, number one. 25 points away from $10,000. Something in a phone book. And you said? The Yellow Pages. 25 points. Our survey said 23. Numbers. Number one answer. Numbers. Have the medic standing by for Marion, please. No, not for me, but Marion, I think. Wanted a birthstone. You said opal. That's a car, isn't it? Sure. It's up to you. 2 points away from $10,000. Our survey said you got it. $10,353. Love ya. See you here on the show.
Every family has one. The smart aleck.
I know the answer.
Okay.
The dummy. The beauty.
We got it.
But only GSN has the new Family Feud.
We're ready to play the feud.
Watch back-to-back episodes of the new Family Feud tomorrow night starting at 11, 10 Central only on GSN.
Get it, huh?